For more than 500,000 Americans with kidney disease, dialysis is a way of life. Alyssa Rossmay shows us a growing trend, dialysis at home.
For the last 5 years, Pam Huffman Papak has been one of thousands of Americans on dialysis. First, she used peritoneal dialysis with a catheter in the abdomen, but suffered infections. Then she used hemodialysis in a Lafayette dialysis center.
I would go 3 days a week for 4 hours and get my dialysis and drive from Rensselaer.
Then she went to Lafayette's Wellbound Dialysis Center. She and her husband were trained on a next stage system, which he helps her use several days a week in the comfort of their own home.
He sets it up and puts me on, and I sit there for 2 hours and about 15 minutes and read and dialyze, and it's just great.
A beauty of home dialysis is when people go home, they aren't locked into a 3-time-a-week, 4-hour schedule like they are if they do dialysis in center. So at home, they can do short dialysis for 2 or 3 hours, maybe 3 days out of four, and they can also do overnight dialysis.
In addition to the convenience it offers, Wellbound Medical Director Dr. Stephen Ash says home hemodialysis is one of the safest choices for treatment of kidney failure.
Part of that is the fact that the patient themselves learn how the dialysis procedure goes for them. They learn their own response to the therapy. So they learn what the normal effects are, and they're very sensitive and very cognizant of anything that's different.
Dr. Ash says patients who use in-home dialysis also have lower hospitalization and infection rates. Huffman Papak says she feels better.
I have a lot more energy. I'm a part-time teacher, so I thought I felt pretty good before, but after being on this just a week or two, it was amazing how much more energy I had.
Patients who use the system go through training on the equipment, have access to 24-hour assistance by phone, and must have a partner in the home. Huffman Papak says for her, the at-home system has been a lifesaver. Alyssa Rossamay, News Channel 18.